In this video, we are going to look at the creation of angle constraints in Autodesk Inventor. I have two components in here and I want to constrain them together. I'm going to start by constraining a couple of axes together here. Then I'm going to make a flush constraint on their sides. So as I look at this one, you can see that it's free to swivel around that axis. And what I'd like to do is apply an angular constraint to control this angle. So I'll begin by starting the Constrain tool, and then I'm going to switch to the Angle option here. Now there are a few different options here. There's directed angle, there's undirected, and then there's the default, the explicit reference vector. So for this one, if I watch my status bar, it tells me to pick the geometry to constrain. So I'm going to pick, say, this plane here, and then the plane underneath here. Now my third selection is going to be an axis. So you have to select an axis with this one, and then I can specify the angle between those. So let's say I wanted a 30 degree angle between them. Notice that it's adding the angle from where they were locked in horizontally. So if I actually wanted 30 between them, then I'm going to need to set this to 150 degrees here. And now I've fully constrained these components. We'll back up here and look at a different way to do this. I'll choose my constraint tool again, switch to angle, and this time I'm going to choose the directed angle option. I'll go ahead and select two planes. This time, instead of selecting the underside of that plane, I'll just go ahead and select this plane up top here. As you can see, it's set to 0 degrees. I can adjust this value. Looks like 30 degrees is going down into the part, so I'm going to change this back to negative 30 to have it come up instead. Then I can click OK. The big difference there was I didn't have to pick an axis. I already had everything constrained, so it was pretty obvious what the axis was going to be in that case. So either method will work. We'll look at another example here, and the big difference here is the lack of rectangular faces for me to constrain to. I'm going to place an axis mate between the two shapes here. And I'll apply that and cancel. You can see it's free to move up and down. And I want to lock the angle in. I don't want to be able to rotate this nut. I also might go ahead and constrain it off of the edge of the part down here in the threaded area. So I'm going to do a quick flush constraint as well between the surfaces here. And then maybe I'll offset it a few millimeters. We'll say -5. There we go. So it's free to rotate. I want to take that ability away. So how can I do that? I don't have a feature up here that I can constrain to. Oftentimes, it makes more sense to constrain between origin planes. So if I expand the origin folder for the bolts, I can see its origin planes. And same thing if I expand the one for the nuts. So I can simply constrain two of those planes together using a mate. So I'll come in here and say XZ plane of the nut and XZ plane of the bolt. And I could do a mate actually in this case. I could also do the angular one. The angular one will actually allow me to go ahead and maybe create a 90 degree relationship between those two if I want. So again, when constraining, you can either select faces or you can select work planes or origin planes. That concludes this look at the angular assembly constraint in Autodesk Inventor.